To understand how yog helps your spiritual growth, you need to first understand what is yog. Patanjali said, Yogaschittavrtiniradha yoga's sattavrtiniradha. It literally means, yog is restraining the mind's behavior. Now what is the mind's nature or how the mind behaves? Mind creates, mind desires. So yog simply means training the mind to be free of desires, free of creations. To understand true meaning of yog, first forget whatever you have been taught or you have heard about yoga from any source whatsoever. Let us try to understand what was the yog that Patanjali described. Yog is simply a process, a system. Patanjali divided yog in 8 stages, namely, yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, pratyahara, dharana, dhyan, samadhi. Now let me try to define these stages in simple words. Stage minus 1. Yam, ethical rules. Yam simply means ethical rules one should follow as a first step towards spirituality. Patanjali described 5 basic ethical rules. Ahimsa, non-violence, satya, truthfulness, asteya, non-stealing, brahmacharya, chastity, aparigraha, non-possessiveness. Now Patanjali says that as a first step towards spirituality, you first need to inculcate these basic moral values in yourself. You should not do violence, you should speak truth, you should not steal, you should follow chastity, you should not be possessive. If you follow these basic rules religiously, then you'll be ready for the next stage. Stage minus 2. Niyam, discipline. Niyam simply means discipline which includes virtuous habits, behaviors and observances. Patanjali has described 5 basic disciplines. Shach, cleanliness of body and mind. Santosh, contentment. Tap, self-discipline. Swade, self-introspection. Study of self. Ishwar Pranidhan, complete surrender to God. Now at this stage Patanjali says that you need to discipline yourself to move further. Once you have followed the above defined disciplines and achieved complete control over them, then you are ready to move to the next stage. Stage 3. Asan, posture. Patanjali says Sthirasikamasanam, an asana is what is steady and pleasant. All the yogic asanas or exercises are designed to make your body stable. So that when you start your sadhana, you can sit in a comfortable posture for long durations. Patanjali says that once you have made your body stable and have achieved complete control over it, then you are ready to move to the next stage. Stage minus 4, pranayam, regulating breath. Patanjali says that now as your body has become stale and you have achieved the right posture, it is time to make your breath stable. At this stage the disciple learns to control the breath sitting in a comfortable posture using various inhaling and exhaling techniques. Patanjali says that once you have made your breath stable, then you are ready to move to the next stage. Stage 5, pratyahara, controlling senses. At this stage the disciple starts trying to control his senses. The target is to retract the sensory experience from external objects. This is the practice to withdraw one's attention from external world towards inner self. Pratyahara is the transition stage where after achieving complete control of body through the first 3 stages one moves towards his inner self. Patanjali says that once you have complete control over your senses, then you are ready to move to the next stage. Stage 6. Dharana, concentration. Patanjali says that now as you have control over your body and senses, it is time to move towards real sadhana, i.e. controlling the mind. At this stage one focuses his mind to one point using the mantra. At this stage one's mind is fixed on a mantra which is repeated over one's breath. Patanjali says that once you have achieved this one-pointedness of mind, you are ready to move to the next stage of sadhana. Stage 7. Dhyan, contemplation, abstract meditation. Dhyan is contemplating whatever dharana has focused on. As one has focused on a mantra, dhyan is its contemplation. Dharana leads to dhyan. Dharana is a state of mind which leads to dhyan, which is a process of mind. In simple words, when you remain focused on a mantra, then that takes you to the state of dhyan automatically. Dhyan is the state where no thought disturbs you, you remain focused on the mantra and eventually you, yourself become the mantra. At this stage nothing remains of the disciple, what remains is only the mantra. Patanjali says that the perfection of this stage will take you to the ultimate stage, the 8th stage. Stage 8, Samadhi, union, trance. Samadhi means oneness with God. At this point there is no difference between the Atma, soul, and Paramatma, ultimate soul. This is what we call Atma Ka Paramatma Samalan, the union of the soul and the ultimate soul. This is called realization, enlightenment. This is what yoga is all about. Yoga is simply a path, a process to reach the ultimate. Tantra and yoga are synonyms. Higher stages of yoga are called tantra. Or you can say early stages of tantra are called yoga by common people. One name of Shiva is Adiyogi and another name of him is Agorishvar. These words are again synonyms. The real sadhana or tantra starts at stage 6. Earlier stages are simply the preparation for sadhana. What we see today in the name of yoga or tantra are the perverted forms of this great practice only. Today what is taught to people in the name of yoga is simply some asanas and some perverted forms of pranayamas. People think that yoga is a way to keep them healthy, it surely is, but yoga goes much beyond that. You go to any yoga center and they'll simply charge you money and start teaching you asanas. They themselves don't know what is the purpose of these asanas. Asanas' purpose is just to give you a comfortable posture, nothing else. And that too comes only after you have followed and mastered the first two stages. Same as with pranayama. One famous Indian yoga guru cum grocery entrepreneur teaches people that by doing a certain pranayama they can reduce their weight. Now what one's breath has to do with one's fat is the secret only known to him. I have always said that a beginner should never get into meditation. Meditation comes at a very later stage. Patanjali says that meditation is the seventh stage. You can go for meditation only when you have a stable body, a calm mind and complete control over your senses. These days all these so-called meditation centers start directly with the seventh stage, where the recipient and the teacher both have no control over anything. This is the reason this meditation never gives any results to anyone other than some flimsy thoughts. People think that through meditation they can calm their minds, but it is actually the other way around. Only a calm and stable mind can do meditation. No one can bypass the system. If you want to really start following yoga, then you must start with first stage, and trust me, each of these stages will take you years to master them, if not lives. Realization doesn't come so cheap. Coming back to your question, can we reach the enlightenment through yoga? No, you cannot reach anywhere closer to spirituality through yoga, which is being taught today. But yes, if you are ready to dedicate your life to yoga as it was told by Patanjali, it can certainly take you towards realization.